Time now for an India Today exclusive. He is the new Sri Lankan Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa's son and biggest confidant. India Today caught up with Namal Rajapaksa, who explained why India should not be worried about Colombo's tango with China. Speaking to our foreign affairs editor Geeta Mohan, Namal reiterated Sri Lanka's age-old cultural ties with India and reassured that the Lankan Tamil community will be no bloodbath in the island nation. Here's our big exclusive.
Parliament, they say, will be convened on the 14th of November, but government officials and ministers have confirmed to India Today that a vote of no confidence certainly will not be taking place on the 14th of November, that it is a process which will take some time. But in the meanwhile, joining me is parliamentarian and son of Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa, Namal Rajapaksa. Many thanks for joining us. The political deadlock, Namal, continues over here. How confident is your party and the Prime Minister that you will have the numbers whenever the vote of no confidence is pushed forward?
Well, we are very confident about that, because we took the decision when we knew we have the numbers. So President Sirisena and Prime Minister Rajapaksa had this discussion for a while, and this decision was taken based on national interest. There is no political or personal interest for us or President Sirisena, because as you know, the previous government, the way things moving forward was not the way that the Sri Lankan community wanted. So they took the decision. We are very confident of the numbers, and of course even on the 14th, when the parliament is convened, as you correctly said, there won't be any no confidence motion coming into parliament, but still we can show our numbers on that day if it's necessary.
What precipitated the matter? What really caused this entire political crisis in Sri Lanka, given that many have the very same question, Namal, mm-hmm. that Sirisena fought Mahinda, and now we're seeing them on the same camp. What really happened?
Well, see, that's all about politics. No? End of the day, the national interest comes first, so the country comes first. So we might have political differences. We might have faced a lot of hardship being in the opposition from the previous government, but end of the day, our politics is based on our policies. So we insisted, President Sirisena and SLFP at that time, you know, the soon as you leave UMP, Ranil Wickremesinghe led UMP, we will decide on merging and move forward, or the other way forward. So as soon as they decided that, of course we have no hesitation of coming into an understanding on policy base, what we're going to do. So that's what happened.
November 7th was the initial date. What really happened? Ranil camp is accusing you, your party, or your government now of horse trading, that you need more time to buy out more MPs.
Well, see, the budget was supposed to be on the 5th of November. So this happened on 26th. So we needed time to settle ourselves and work on our policies, and work on our budget, and work on our cabinet, and what we are going to do for next 6 months. See, as I earlier stated, our purpose was not to topple the government, but to make sure that we implement our policies once we come back. So if our purpose was purely to kick out Mr. Wickremesinghe, then it's fair enough. We can go to parliament and say, okay, you're out. But no, that's not our purpose. We want to run the country smoothly. We want to bring back the economic, social and political stability. So we need to work on our policies. So we are working on our policies, and as soon as we convey parliament on the 14th, we will lay down our policies and we will work towards a betterment.
I see a lot of stress on policies. And what do you mean by your policies? How is Sirisena Mahinda policy any different from Sirisena Ranil policy? What was the difference over there between the president and the then prime minister?
Well, the policies are going to come forward for next few months will be people's friendly policy. The Sri Lankan interest will be looked after. The interest of the region will be looked after.
And when you say Sri Lankan interest, do you mean Ranil was not looking at Sri Lankan interest?
See, he is more concentrating on the Western interest rather than Sri Lankan interest. If you look at even the speeches now he makes, you know, he's depending on the West, not on the Sri Lankan people. If he says that his removal is unconstitutional, go to courts. He's not going to courts. If not, let's go to people. Let people decide. Right, and he's complaining that President Rajapaksa's government and President Sirisena's government trying to buy people. So then why are you sticking into the people? Let's go for election.
Why do you say that he's not going to the courts? And what would really happen constitutionally in terms of your own parliamentary rules if he really goes to court?
See, the president acted upon the constitution. The 19th Amendment, the Article 48 of the 19th Amendment clearly says that the single is translation prevails, because the constitution at section 23 of the national constitution, Sri Lankan constitution, clearly says that the law can be only passed in Sinhalese and English. But if there's a conflict of the Sinhalese and English, Sinhalese and Tamil, if there's a conflict in the constitution, then the original act, the law that been passed, the language will be taken into consideration. But the article 48 of the 19th amendment clearly says the 19th amendment is passed in Sinhalese. The Sinhalese act prevails over any other piece of paper. So in this case, president act purely based on constitution. The article 46 of the constitution clearly says about removal of the prime minister. But the English, and article 46 also says that if the national government is dissolved, or the national government is ended, then the cabinet of ministers dissolved then and there. So which includes the prime minister. Not only that, you go to article 48, there's a dispute between Sinhalese and English act. I must say that.
Yes, the removal bit.
The removal bit. Okay. So the English says it can be removed on by death, but the Sinhalese says the prime minister, president has the mandate to remove. So Mr. Vikramasinghe gives the English translation which doesn't have any binding on the Sri Lankan constitution
to the world.
And he is not talking about the Sinhalese translation. This is a piece of legislation done by himself.
Okay, the larger picture, Namal. Given that you're a parliamentarian, you're in the thick of things, you know what is really happening. In the event of a vote of no confidence, even if Mahinda Rajapaksa, the Prime Minister, loses the vote of confidence or loses the majority in the House, then will Ranil Wickremesinghe have a chance to continue or to become Prime Minister again?
Well, President Sirisena has clearly said in open media, by addressing the nation, that he will not go ahead with former Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe. The Constitution gives the will to the President, the right to the President to decide, the mandate to the President to decide who is going to be the next Prime Minister.
So it will be anyone but Ranil?
See, end of the day, if President Sirisena doesn't agree with the policies of UMP, he will not go with UMP again, right? So we are confident of our numbers, and we have more than 118 with us, and we are confident to face the no confidence motion. We will turn the no confidence motion into a confident motion against Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa, and we will show to the public, to the world, that the strength, not only the public but the parliament majority, is with President Sirisena and Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa. But if honorable former Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe is trying to play politics out of it for his own survival, because we all know what he's going through in his own political party, right? For his survival in the party, he needs to hold on there. Either he needs to at least to have the opposition leadership, otherwise he will, according to the UMP constitution, he will lose the party.
Okay, so then there are two things over here. One, has Ranil Wickremesinghe overstayed his welcome at Temple Trees? Because if he's not going to be Prime Minister at all, then he should be leaving that official residence. Secondly, there is no way that Ranil Wickremesinghe is going to be Prime Minister if he does not enjoy the confidence of the President. But his camp is saying if that does not happen, there will be bloodbath. So what do you have to say to the two things, that he overstayed his welcome and that they're talking about a bloodbath after Sri Lanka saw the worst kind of crisis a decade ago?
Well, see, I mean, Prime Minister Wickremesinghe is a very senior politician, and he has been the Prime Minister of Sri Lanka for thrice. He has faced this kind of situation during President Chandrika's government as well, after 2.5 years. And at least this time he stayed for 3.5 years. So he is a former Prime Minister, so we have some sort of respect for him. You know, we are not going to force him out. We will expect him to act more mature and take serious political decisions, and also not mislead the public. But UMP talking of a blood, you know, that's in their party. If you look at 83 riots, who is responsible? It's a UMP who is responsible. If you look at LTT, why did LTT created? It's all because of the policies that were taken by the UMP. Why did JVP youth from the south took arms? Because against UMP policies. So we all know that what UMP as a party is capable of. But we must assure, we will make sure the law and order is maintained, and public will not take arms against UMP, because public has been misled twice, once in north with the Tamils, secondly in south with Sinhalese. So the Sri Lankan community is not willing to share blood to protect Prime Minister Wickremesinghe or UMP.
One critical factor is the other Tamil parties. Are you engaging with the Tamil parties? Which way are they headed? Because right now they're not as inclined as you would like them to be.
Well, see, we do engage with the Tamil parties, but unfortunately those Tamil parties doesn't engage with the Tamil community. They represent their own party, not the community. They represent their own interest, not the community. That is the problem with the Sri Lankan Tamil parties. Majority of the Tamil parties does not represent the Tamil community. They are not listen. Last 3.5 years, what did TNA get from UMP? What did Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe give to TNA? Nothing. Only Sambandhan got the opposition leadership. He goes to Trincomalee, he addresses youth and says, please don't ask anything from me, please don't ask employment from me. I want to bring a constitutional amendment for you. But did he bring that? The government had two-third majority in the parliament. The government had two-third majority in the parliament, but they did not bring a constitutional amendment. Honorable Sambandhan was in the co-chairing committee, steering committee of the constitution, but nothing happened. So the TNA as a political party, unfortunately, does not represent the Tamil community in Sri Lanka.
But will you and your party and your government represent the interests of the Tamils here? Will we look at an amendment coming through? Because that did not happen even in the past when Rajapaksa was president.
We had a process. We had challenges to face. We had a war to fight. So we ended the war. We ended reconciliation. Not ended as in we started reconciliation. We rehabilitated 12,500 LTT cadres. We employed Tamil youth. For the first time in the Sri Lankan history, the northern youth got an opportunity to come into the government sector. And they became teachers, they became doctors, they became engineers. They were part of the entire education process, the government employment process. So we were taking one step at a time. And we were moving forward. But unfortunately, and the development, we invested more than $1 billion. The Indian government helped us to rebuild the railway line to Jaffna, Yaldevi. But we invested more than $1 billion on infrastructure. We built hospitals, schools. Okay. But what did Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe's government, with the support of the TNA, TNA, mind you, voted for every single budget of Mr. Wickremesinghe, every single budget. They voted for him for the no confidence motion. But what did they get? What did the Tamil community get out of supporting Honorable Prime Minister, former Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe's government? They didn't get anything.
Okay. So are the chances that the Tamil parties might look at voting for them, or are there also talks of them abstaining?
I think they are confused at the moment because they might be more, because I don't know what sort of personal affiliation they have with Honorable former Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe, but they seem to be having a very close communication and affiliation. I don't know whether it's based on some personal interest or political interest, but definitely that interest is not the interest of the Tamil community. But we can see that a lot of Tamil TNA MPs who are with people are joining the government at the moment. We already have one MP from Batiklo. Mm-hmm. Who has joined. So we are seriously looking at bringing back the economy of the entire country, including the north, and creating more employment to the right. To the youth.
Right. Finally, coming to the question of India and India's concerns vis-a-vis Sri Lanka, it is closely watching what is happening in terms of the political crisis in Sri Lanka, but there have been concerns in the past with regards to the Rajapaksa government of the time. Many believed that he was very close to China and that the Chinese influence will grow in this if he returns. Is that a concern that requires assuaging by the Rajapaksa regime?
See, we had a very strong bilateral relationship with many countries, not only China, not only India, but many European countries as well. If you look at the investments that came to Sri Lanka, you know, it came from Europe, it came from India, it came from China. But last few years, the India-China-Sri Lankan relationship was misled and miscommunicated, to be honest. Mm-hmm. So we are going to keep the history aside. You know, we're looking for a future. We want India-Sri Lanka relationship to be robust and resilient. And we are neighbors. We have been in diplomatic and cultural bond for a very long time. The religion and the cultural bond is much more stronger between Sri Lanka and India than our diplomatic ties. So we want to build a strong, robust and resilient relationship with India. At the same time, my father's government, the previous government and current government has clearly stated that the Sri Lankan land, water, air will not be given the opportunity to used against any of our neighboring countries, and we will make sure we stand by that. But the Chinese investments were purely based on investment. And if someone is arguing about China's influence growing, it was the last 3 years. Because last 3 years under Prime Minister Vikramasinghe's government, we had a very strong commercial relationship with China. And they have helped us tremendously to build infrastructure. If you look at Hambantota Port, it was offered to India. The Mattale Airport was offered to India. But nothing happened. But end of the day, we as Sri Lankan politicians, we have to look after our interests. The people of Sri Lanka should be looked after. More employment should be created. So we went to China. They were generous enough to come and start. And they immediately started the project. But all those projects are based on commercial transactions.
So are you saying that relationship between Sri Lanka and China is purely economic, and relationship between in Sri Lanka and India more strategic than economic?
Yes, of course. I mean, end of the day, the economic relationship is what matters in modern days. So even India, Sri Lankan relationship, we had to grow more investment coming in from India to Sri Lanka and use Sri Lanka as a hub for transshipment. Because Sri Lanka is purely a great hub for India and for the subcontinent to use it as a transit destination with our ports and aviation, because we have done the infrastructure. It's a matter of getting into, it's a matter of kicking those projects forward, you know, taking those projects forward. So the Sri Lankan interest with China, or the Chinese interest in Sri Lanka, with Chinese government has been very clear, it's purely based on investments.
What about projects that were given to India during the Ranil government? Will they stay, or will that be a problem, including the East terminal that has been a contentious issue lately?
See, we have a policy of non-privatization, but we are welcoming foreign investments, and we are looking at strategic partnership more than, you know, any other partnership. And our policy has always been clear. My father's policy has always been very clear that we are looking for investments, but we will not look at purely privatization. If my father wanted that during his government, we should have given Hambantota Port then and there. But no, we took a loan and we built it and we repaid. We have repaid up to $600 million up to today from the revenue that generated by the port, not from the tax money collected by the people of Sri Lanka, but the revenue generation we have paid. So we are not looking at privatization, but of course all agreements, not only related to India or China or Europe, all agreements we have to go through it again. We had certain criticisms about certain agreements and certain clauses, so we will start renegotiating.
Well, final question to you. You're a parliamentarian yourself. Will you serve under your prime minister in this government, or will you wait it out for another 1.5 years to really be a minister in the government?
Well, see, this is my second term in parliament, but we have decided majority of us are going to be seated as member of parliament rather than taking portfolios. But you know, this is the first step of the bigger picture. So we are looking at a strong coalition government from the next parliamentary election. So this happened suddenly, purely based on political and national interest. So we are looking at putting the economy and political stability back. So we'll let that go forward, and we will work for the next election.
Working for the next election, but very confident that they are going to continue with the government that has been formed between Sirisena and Mahinda Rajapaksa. Speaking with me was Namal Rajapaksa, parliamentarian and son of the Prime Minister of Sri Lanka. With video journalist Arvinda in Colombo, Geeta Mohan for India Today.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.